Good morning, all. It is in Holland, it's the second Easter day. I bet you're laughing because I don't think that's done anywhere but in Europe, some countries at least. So we have second Easter day. People all go to those, you know, really big furniture shops, and some go to the really big outlets where you can buy garden plants and check out some garden furniture and barbecues and all that stuff. It's a traditional thing. Some people go for really, really long walks in the woods, forest, and the weather is holding up. It's sunny as we speak, but it's not going to stay like that. We're going to have some rain. So thank you all for tuning in to watch. And of course, I have here my donation list. And look at that. I found out how to do columns. Isn't that fantastic? I've never done that before. You know, even at work, I had some people send me a Word document, and they had these columns. And then I thought, man, how do they do that? And I was always looking at the tables, where you make a table and you can choose how many rows and how many horizontal squares. And that just didn't work. And now I found out how to do it. So thank you, the person on YouTube, for telling me to find out how to do that. Thank you. Oh, sometimes I'm pretty stupid. Okay. Yeah, I am stupid because, you know, this is like child's play. And I am, you know, give me Photoshop with 6 million variables and I can find that out. But Word documents, oh boy. I think it's just because I don't like it. I don't like to do this stuff. I'm really bad with everything that has to do with administration. I don't like it. I have drawers. Like, everything that's done, I throw in a drawer, and everything that's not done, I throw in another drawer. That's my system. Okay, let's round a few things up. First thing, I'm very happy with the people that donated, because, you know, that's where I buy all my canvases and paint with. You guys, because Royal Talons won't do it, so too bad, Royal Talons. I love my people who watch, so that's it. So I'm going to put this away before it starts to flicker and I get all those flickering comments, because don't want to cause headaches. Then I'll do a little roundup for the people that are thinking now, stop chatting and get on with what you're doing. Fast forward and you won't have any problem with it. So this is the little galaxy painting. I'm so done with it, people. I don't like it. I think I'd like to do this with, you know, a child or something, that I could help them make it, and that would be a lot of fun, but it's just not where my passion is, doing a galaxy painting. And I think I could have done a little bit better job, but I'm finished with it, so there it goes. Then yesterday we had the experiment with the three different mediums. So I will start with the worst. The worst was this one, where it's only water and paint and silicone, of course. Can you see how the cells already broke up? Even you know, just leveling, they all start to break up. And for me, that is pretty much, you know, a disaster. And then look at all the pinholes. That was something. There's like 6 million pinholes in here. And I used the same silicone, not out of the can, no spraying in. So that's another thing. If you use too much water, you're going to get those pinholes. And then here in the middle, it started breaking up. Look at that. It just broke up totally. Can you see it? Yeah. So that's no good. So when I had it on the out of the cup, I could already see that it was the colors were breaking up. And that is because you're using way, way, way too much water and the binder of the paint can't hold up. And if I hadn't torched it, it would have given a pretty pattern, but it's all about the cells, right? So this is not something to do. If you want to do some acrylic pouring, you will have to add some sort of a medium in there. Then we go to the next one. This one is the PVA, and this one is the gloss varnish. It wasn't medium, it was the gloss varnish. Because the gloss medium would act the same as pouring medium. So this is the very, very cheap varnish I used. And the cells kept beautifully. It's all dried up, so see how it's dry? Everything's dry. And those really nice long cells, and it kept. Maybe the colors are not as bright as I would want them, but I think the colors are also a little muted because I tilted it a lot. But other than that, you know, the definition is beautiful. So I'm very happy with that one. And then we have the last one, that is the PVA. And for the people, you know, there were some people asking, hey, if you live in Holland, this is the varnish gloss. And it is used for just, you know, the surface gloss, but you can do anything with it, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, they just say it's for varnishing. So it's from Crayel. That's the brand, and the varnish gloss. And you have it in matte too, so. Then the this one, this is the Super PVA Craft Medium. This is it. And I buy it here, this guy, this shop, Becker Ross, sells it. This is so cheap, you wouldn't even believe it. I think a liter was like $6.95. Compare that to a liter of pouring medium, 30 some dollars, so euros. So this is very, very cheap. And that's what we did this one with. So what I found out, if you're gonna do the PVA, you do have to thin it out with water. And you have to make sure that your canvas is very, very level when you do this. Because I tipped mine, if you can see, it ran down here. Here's the thick bit. And if you get it too thick, it starts to crack, like you see here. But this whole bit, this worked out fine. So even, you know, the definition of these cells is just beautiful. So what you want to do is thin it out. Make sure it's not too thick, because otherwise it starts to crack. And you sort of make sure that when you're going to let it dry, that it is level, very, very level. That's very important. But of all three pieces, I'll put them together. Look at this. This is so vibrant compared to those. This is so beautiful. I'm going to be doing a couple of more with that. Even these cells are really beautiful. And this, the bottom, I am really, this is stunning. I love that. Okay, put them away. Oh, and then the other ones, the records. This is one of the records. Very beautiful, very dry. And this is the light one. Look at that lacing. How beautiful is that? Haha, I love it. And I might even go to the shop this afternoon to buy some ferns to put in it. Then I have the canvas. This is what the canvas did. Also beautiful. I really like it. Some really nice small cells, and I like this, the waves at the on the outer rim. I love it. Okay, now what are we gonna do? Someone asked me, you know, they watched my video with the really cheap acrylic paint and they said, you know, why don't you give it a real go? Because you put all those colors in there, and because of all those colors, it's sort of a, yeah, a bit of a mess. So why don't you give it a really good go? So I thought, okay, let's do that. But I thought, let's go on a real budget. Like, you didn't have any money at all to do this. So what I did, I mixed only two colors of blue, those two colors, and I mixed the white. And instead of putting pouring medium in, which is very expensive, I know, and a lot of people can't afford it, I put only Floetrol. Had to get some cups. So I only did Floetrol, a little bit of water, like about 5%. So there's 50-50. There's 50% paint, 50% Floetrol, and there's 5% water in all three. And then in the white, I put the silicone. It's getting warm in here. So what I do is this is the silicone, and this is the silicone out of the spray. But I spray it outside so it fills the little bottle, and then every time I walk past the bottle, I give it a little shake. And in the beginning you'll see a lot of foam, and that's what causes the pinholes. So this is still pretty new because I filled this yesterday, and you can still see the it foam a little, but after 2 or 3 days it's totally gone. So I let it rest. So there's only silicone here in the white. I let it rest for a while, so I'm hoping it's gonna work. And we're gonna do it on a big canvas. The canvas is 30 by 40, I think. And people in Holland will know that this is the Action sort. Let's see how big it was. Oh yeah, 30 by 40. So I buy this at the, like, a dollar store. And they have them now, they have a sort of a, how do you call it? They give you these for $1, well, 1 euro, so that's $1.07. But that is still a good deal. It's nice and tight, and we're gonna be pouring on it. Okay, let's put this aside. And another thing I was gonna ask you guys, if anyone comments on this video, just put your comment in what you wanna say or ask. But could you also put in on the end of your comment, audio okay or audio not okay, something like that? Because it's driving me crazy, to tell you the truth. Every time I upload these videos, I go check on the tablet, I check on my phone, and I check on my PC, my desktop. And my sound is perfectly okay. I can't even turn it up because it's so loud. And I still keep getting people that are saying, I've got it up as high as I can put it up and I can't hear you. So I'm not sure what's going on. And then when someone complains, there are another few people that say, no, the volume is fine. So I'm thinking it's a sort of a YouTube thing. So if you could check that out for me, that would be really cool. Okay, let's do the pour. I have no coffee. That really sucks big time. No coffee at all. Well, I'll go get coffee in a bit. Okay, so what we have here is the white with the silicone and two colors blue. Let's put a little on top here. I don't want that much of that white. We will be getting a lot of white, but I'm planning on our sort of counting on the blue going with the white and giving sort of a really light blue also. So do we do a flip cup or shall I just pour it? See, now would be nice if you guys could say what you want. Well, let's do both. Nah, we can't do both. Let's just turn it around like this. And there we go. Wow, look at that. That is pretty nice. I like the cells. But is it enough? Let's look. Oh, these cells are going to be huge by the time I fill the canvas. Well, just might, you know, give a little special touch, who knows. I can spread it out pretty, look at those cells. They look with the size. They are huge. And I will be torching it, so let's just see what it does. How big do you want cells? I've never seen cells this big. Oh, it's funny. Okay, I'm mixing up some more paint for the corners. Hoping I'm having enough. Okay, a little swirl here. Then I'm gonna be pouring along here. Just like that. And letting it come off there a little bit. Then it's time for my palette knife. Because my palette knife needs to pick up some paint. I do want it covered totally, so that's what I'm going for. And the last one. There we go. Okay. I think we got it covered. That is pretty. Oops, I forgot this bit. I need my palette knife. It is kind of pretty, but I think I would like to let it go down a little bit like here. Just a bit, just to give it a little change. That's it. Okay, I think that's what we want. And now we're gonna torch it. So I'm gotta get myself a little cloth. And I am going to be very excited if a lot of cells pop up. We shall see. So okay, we have two torches, and I'll just throw it in there, guys. It's a culinary torch, the one they use to make crème brûlée, because people still keep asking me. And there we go. And it wow, that is beautiful. Wow, didn't expect to do that. I should get out my really big torch. If this doesn't look like the sea, then I don't know what does. But it needs a lot of torching because it's so big. But I'm not sure those cells are going to keep the people. Okay, almost ready. Almost ready. I do want to get those air bubbles out also. This is a lot of torching. Okay. Wow, that is pretty. And I'm gonna make sure that I level it out because I don't want it to tip over so it, you know, bulges or something like that. Okay, I'm gonna get you guys down and show you what I did. Look at that. Is that amazing? That is pretty, isn't it? I like it. Just take you back a little bit so you can see the whole thing. It is beautiful. I like it. Look at those cells. I'm speechless because I like it so much. Oh. This is so pretty. And just think, you know, only two colors of blue and one white, and there's only silicone in the white. Maybe I'm onto something because I always put silicone in every single color. But look at this, you don't even need all colors filled with silicone. There's just silicone in the white. That is beautiful. Okay, guys, I'm going to put this up and then make sure you have something to watch while you're drinking coffee with me, which I like. And I'll see you, I think, later today. I don't know who that is. Oh, okay, I think I'll see you guys later today because I have to pick up a computer somewhere. And someone fixed one of my old computers. I want to have a computer upstairs, so maybe... later on today I'll do another video. Thank you all for watching and give me a thumbs up if you like it, people. Please let us wipe out those thumbs down with the thumbs up. That would be really nice. So thank you all for watching and see you in the next video.